It is an inappropriate overreach for the State Board of Education to reverse a local board's decision and then require that local board to enforce a mandate or risk their funding. This is much more than a mask requirement. That, Brian Neiman and audience, part of a statement released yesterday by the Republican members of the Maryland State Senate, and they are part of the Joint Committee on Administrative, Executive, and Legislative Review, otherwise known as AELR, after a 10-7 vote, Brian, that says yes, all 24 jurisdictions must comply with the State Department of Education's mandate that there be a mask in every school and children wear a mask. Joining us right now is a member of that committee, State Senator Steve Hershey. Good morning, Senator.
Good morning, C4. Good morning, Brian.
Good to have you on, sir.
Look, let's talk about what happened in yesterday's hearing. Yes, I did watch a good part of the hearing where people came and testified in front of you about this mask mandate. Why do you and the other Republican members feel so strongly, Senator Hershey, about this type of local control?
Well, listen, C4, in Annapolis, the Democrats have been drilling down into us that all school decisions are made at the local level. I mean, we've heard this so often. The most recent fight was when the governor put in executive order to start schools after Labor Day. And all we kept hearing was that local control, this is where school decisions need to be made. All of a sudden, they come out to, the, you know, yesterday or, you know, 2 weeks ago with the State Board of Education. And they said, no, we're going to decide that this is going to be different. And we're going to make a broader decision at the state level that's going to affect each and every county in the way that they had already decided on the best way to protect their students at the local level from the pandemic. And so, you know, that's where we came up with, you know, again, pointed out the hypocrisy of all of this and said, you know, we are at the same position. We believe that the local school boards, many of them in the state are elected by the citizens of those counties, are the best, is the best body to make these types of decisions. And, you know, yesterday the Democrat leadership decided, oh, no, not in this case. State level decisions are better off here.
Do you think this will be challenged, A, and B, do you think that it is up to legal muster?
You know, I don't think it will be challenged. And I think the evidence of that is if you remember when the State Board of Education made this decision, there were multiple counties that had already decided that they were not going to require masks. By the time we got to the joint hearing yesterday, really only two counties had held out, Carroll County and Somerset County. The other counties, I think, saw the writing on the wall. As C4 mentioned, it was a 19-member committee with 12 Democrats on it. They need 10 votes. I mean, the outcome was not surprising. And I think that that the other counties already had decided that we can move forward. I mean, at the end of the day, they do want to do the best things that's possible for the kids. And they do, they, you know, they don't want to start schools that you don't have to wear masks and then all of a sudden have to go into that. So I think that's why we saw a lot of school systems already just move forward with a mask requirement.
State Senator Steve Hershey is on board with us. He is a member of the AELR committee. That committee is made up of Senate members and House members, joint committee, and they voted yesterday 10-7 to approve the mask mandate from the State Department of Education. I want to ask you a broader question, Senator, though, because this was part of that raised my eyebrow. When the Attorney General of the state of Maryland, Brian Frosch, released a statement saying that the state school board could mandate something for local jurisdictions and kind of gave them a roadmap. I was like, where was that opinion last year? Brian and I were both saying, where was that opinion last year when Governor Hogan was looking to get schools to open and that type of thing? It just seemed very convenient for the AG to weigh in now, Senator.
Absolutely. I mean, again, that's the way Annapolis operates, unfortunately. And, you know, and again, don't think for a minute that this isn't being driven by the teachers union as well, too. And, you know, I pointed that out in our committee hearing yesterday that President Teachers Union was on board in full support of the mask mandate. And I specifically asked her and I said, you know, if we're really concerned about the health and welfare of the students, I said, where is the teachers union with regards to mandated vaccinations? And again, I'm not for mandated vaccinations,
right,
but I'm just trying to point out the hypocrisy of what they do. Oh, no, we're not, you know, we're not against that. I mean, she must have danced around that bush so many times. And finally, it, you know, it came out. And the reality that we all know is the teachers union has not been, in their minds, properly incentivized to make that switch over and to make that requirement. You know, even in a pandemic, the teachers union you know, are not going to do anything unless they are somehow compensated for or they get something out of it. So, you know, again, we just continue to see the levels of hypocrisy that go on there. We continue to see what's good in one condition is not good in another condition. And as you saw from Attorney General Frost, they will bend over backwards to try to find the rightly phrased letter that allows them to do something that just a year ago they were thinking the exact opposite.
But along those lines, then you'd believe that the state school board and the state school superintendents via, you know, Brian Frosch would be able to mandate that teachers have to be vaccinated. All teachers in the state have to be vaccinated in order to teach in the classroom. Would that be possible?
I asked that question point blank of the superintendent Chaudhary and asked him that. And again, they deflected that and they said, well, vaccination questions are health related. You know, that's a medicine. That's something that a health department, local health officers, they would have to make that decision. Something like masking and social distancing. Oh, yeah, we can make that type of decision and we'll go forward with that.
State Senator Hershey, you know, the Baltimore Sun is reporting. We asked Secretary of Health, Dennis Schrader, who's just on in the last segment with us about this. But I want to get your take. The Sun is reporting that more than half of the school systems in Maryland may institute routine testing for unvaccinated students or staff, and they say in an effort to tamp down the spread. But one of the concerns we were talking about is, are you separating the unvaccinated from the vaccinated? And Secretary Schrader said, no, they'd probably be testing everybody. What do you know, if anything, about this routine testing that might be going on in schools, Senator?
I've heard parents are already outraged at the thought that a public school system would be testing their child. You know, again, this is something that we have been able to get through this forever with the flu. If your son or daughter is sick, they've stayed home. We've been able to manage things in that perspective. And now all of a sudden we're gotten into a situation where testing is going to occur at the school level. I don't think you're going to see that go forward. And again, this is something the teachers union came back and they said, okay, we're in favor of vaccine and testing, i.e. if you are vaccinated, then that's one thing. Mm-hmm. If you're not, the teachers union is okay with testing. But having to test children every certain period of time, I don't think that's going to, you know, go over very easily, and I certainly don't think that is warranted.
Hmm. All right, so masking then is not a health issue. I'm just trying to figure that out. Aren't we wearing masks for the health of our students?
And that's exactly. I mean, it's you know, when you start asking these questions, C4, you've done it before. You just are amazed at some of the answers that you get. But the fun part about asking these questions is the follow up questions, and that's what I repeatedly asked him about that. And I said, you know, again, explain this to me and explain this to the committee, and that's how they deflected it, and that's how they said, well, we don't want to be in the position of mandating vaccinations again because the teachers union's holding a hammer over them and saying, you know, we don't want that to occur, but we can mandate the masking. And they thought that because of that was not a medical type of treatment, I forget the exact words that he used, but that was different scenario than an actual medical vaccination.
What does it? Do you read anything into our new state school superintendent Chaudhary going along with this?
I mean, of course. I mean, you know, again, the Superintendent Chaudhary is appointed by the school board. The school board is nominated by the governor, but again, goes through the executive nomination process and is confirmed by the Senate. At the end of the day, you know, he is certainly more accountable to the school board than to any other an entity out there. And that school board, once they are confirmed, by the Senate, you know, it's not like a department agency where the secretary is always accountable to the governor.
Right.
These school boards now and these types of boards are accountable to those that have the last say, and that's the Senate Executive Nominations Committee and the Senate that approved their nomination.
I think Brian's point, though, we kind of see a lean here that is kind of evident in terms of particularly pro either teachers side or that particularly leaning. But State Senator Hershey, I've got to ask you, it's related to schools, but a different thing other than COVID. There's a report out from Project Baltimore that about 6,000 kids from all over the state that school systems were paid for didn't go to school. In other words, they were ghost students or vacant students to the tune of $92 million. And I guess the big question is, shouldn't we require that students be attending before we pay school systems, Senator Hershey?
Absolutely. And C4, you know, you and I talked about this last year when we saw the movement from to private school.
Yep.
And how much, remember, Montgomery County fought back so vehemently because they see each one of these students with a price tag around their neck.
Yep.
Each one of these students that show up in their school system brings along, you know, $13,000 to $20,000 in funding for them. So they are trying to get that enrollment number up as high as they possibly can. And because we had pointed that out and we had talked about this again last year, the General Assembly last year said, well, it doesn't matter last year. We're going to hold everybody harmless. Mm-hmm. on the declining enrollment last year. So now the school systems have recognized, well, we don't have to worry about this. We don't have to worry about if we have a certain amount of people, students that show up here or not. We don't have to worry about this. We know the General Assembly is going to come to the rescue, and they're going to fully fund us with the amount of money that we made it or got last year or even better.
Yeah.
Incredible.
And I was told by my kid's principal the other day that we had to make sure that we had two masks because they didn't have any extra supplies left in case a kid forgot his mask or damaged it. I mean, all of the money that goes to the school system, all of the hundreds of millions of dollars that have gone to school systems that we were told had to pass in order to get kids back in school, and we can't afford to buy a box of masks for schools. I mean, it's just absurd.
It is. And you know, I brought this same question up yesterday. I mean, I said, who's specifically going to enforce these mask mandates? And again, I get a very broad response. Well, the State Board of Education. And I shot back at the superintendent. I said, you're going to put people in every school and make sure that these kids are wearing a mask? Oh, no. Well, we're going to tell the local school boards that they have to enforce it. And I said, the same local school boards that you thought were incapable of making these decisions at first, now you're going to tell them that they have to enforce that. And I said, but take it a step further. I said, who's enforcing it in the classroom? I mean, are you butting teachers up against students for, you know, having to stop the classroom to tell, you know, a student that, you know, hey, you need to pull your mask above your nose. Hey, you need to put your mask on. And I said, and then what happens if a student isn't compliant? I said, are they getting, you know, suspended?
Right.
Are we suspending kids as a result of this? Oh, no. Of course, we're not going to do that. So there really isn't an enforcement mechanism. And I was surprised to hear him say that they could look at withholding funding.
Yep.
As a result of this. And, you know, again, that is just another step that, you know, when we talk about the abuse of power, when we talk about an overreach, to just think that a state school board would consider holding funding back because children aren't wearing masks in their classroom is just ridiculous.
Incredible. State Senator Steve Hershey, as always, we appreciate your time and insight. And it was interesting watching that hearing yesterday and the logic train, as I call it, being derailed many times. I appreciate your time, Senator.
It certainly was. And thank you guys for all you do.
I appreciate it. State Senator Steve Hershey from the Eastern Shore talking about the hearing yesterday, the AELR hearing. And Brian, this is the whole thing that just gets me. I want to go back to last year we were told over and over again, the State Department of Education and the governor cannot overrule when it comes to education at the local level. And here they just do it willy-nilly yesterday.
Yeah.
They just pass, vote on it.
It's because it's political.
Yeah.
And it's going to work for them in order to do it. And that's the way they wanted to go. Even though if it really is about safety, you're going to make sure that every teacher is vaccinated no matter what, or they can't work. But they don't want to do that. They don't want to go that far.
The mask is now more important than the vaccine, I guess.
It is, and it's absurd. You know, it's like body armor versus, you know, a little plastic frisbee to protect you, as far as I'm concerned. And then, you know, the masking aspect of it, you have to wear a mask. And we had all of this money for the PPE for these schools that has been spent apparently in other ways, because I looked at the breakdown of my county the other day, and there was only $20 million that was earmarked for health
Incredible.
And safety, which
Incredible.
I assume, though, was for hand sanitizer and PPE and ventilation. And yet they don't have masks to hand out to kids in case they don't have one or didn't bring one or forgot it or it was damaged. I mean, this is the stuff that drives you absolutely nuts. Why did we do all of these things? Why do we have these policies in place if they can either not be enforced or they don't make sense or they are inconsistent? And they're all of the above, it seems.
By the way, there still will be today another day of Baltimore City Public Schools being closed for lack of air conditioning and bad ventilation.
Yeah.
And what was the money supposed to go for again, Brian? a lot of the people?
Ventilation, yes. Ventilation was huge. And it is a big part of it, which is, you know, something that is fixable. But that was a part of a five-year plan,
C4.
They're on pace. They'll get the air conditioning at some point next year. But throw up your hands and say, this is our government.
It really is.
It's not just government. It's governments.